Welcome to the Essentials of Inorganic Chemistry. I am your friend Dr. V.D. Bhatt, and presently I am discussing a chapter on symmetry. This is the fifth talk in the series. This talk is in continuation of the previous four talks, and therefore, if you are new, I request you to go back and attend the first four talks, then only you will be able to understand this talk. Today I intend to discuss a few point groups like C3V point group, C infinite V point group, CNH point group, CS point group, CI point group, and I will begin with the multiplication table for C3V point group. Friends, the examples of C3V point group are ammonia, phosphine, Ca3- ion, etc. In addition to the identity element E, the C3V point group contains two rotational operators, that is C3 and C3 square. Moreover, it also contains three vertical planes of symmetry, that is sigma VA. We may label them as sigma VA, sigma VB, and sigma VC. Here, eventually you will see that the commutation relation is not maintained. We will take the example C3 multiplied by sigma VA, and we will see that sigma VA multiplied by C3 is not equal to the C3 multiplied by sigma VA, which means that the C3V point group is a non-abelian point group. In fact, you will see that C3 multiplied by sigma VA is going to be equal to sigma VB, while sigma VA multiplied by C3 is going to be equal to sigma VC. So, while preparing the multiplication table for our C3V point group, we'll take this figure as our reference. See here, we have got ammonia molecule, and then I have labeled the hydrogen atoms as HA, then HB, and HC. We all know now that a line passing through the nitrogen atom is going to be the C3 axis. And here I have shown the results of various operations that are carried out on the ammonia molecule. Now straight away let us go to the multiplication table. We have already discussed the multiplication table for C2V point group, taking the example of water molecule. In this multiplication table, we know that the sequence of operation being important, it has to be indicated. So in the first row, we are showing that the first operation is the operation shown in the columns, whereas the second operation is the operation shown in the rows. So the first step is to make a table with suitable number of rows and columns. Ideally, it has to contain two more rows and columns than the number of elements of symmetry in that particular point group. In this case, we see that it has two rotational operators, three planes of symmetry, that is 5, and then the identity element 6. And in addition to that, we need to have two rows. Now, in the first main row, we will be listing all the elements of symmetry in a particular sequence. As such, this sequence is not very important, but you have to maintain the same sequence in the column and the row, then only it will be easy for you to write down the multiplication table. So you have identity element first, then you have C3, then C3 square, sigma VA, B and C. Next comes the first column. The first column, you will again be writing all the elements of symmetry in the same sequence as that you wrote in the case of the row. Now, we remember that the sequence of operation is like you have to go first down and then go left. That is how it goes. So, you know, the first cell is like e multiplied by e is equal to e. I have already said time and again that e is like number 1 in mathematics. When you multiply it with anything, it will return the same number. So e multiplied by e is always equal to e. Next is c3 multiplied by e. So that is also going to be c3. Then comes c3 square multiplied by e. c3 square. So in this entire row, you will see that since the second operation is identity operation, the result will be the first operation only. So it is very easy to write down the first row. Let us go to the second row. Now you have e multiplied by c3. So that again is going to be c3. Next is c3 multiplied by c3. We know it very well that c3 multiplied by c3 is c3 square. Then c3 square multiplied by c3. See, here you have to remember a relation. Cn raised to n is always equal to e. Now c3 square multiplied by c3 is equal to c3 cube, and c3 cube is equal to cn raised to n. Therefore that value comes out to be e. Then comes this operation, sigma va multiplied by c3. So for that we have to refer our figure, sigma va multiplied by c3. So this is the operation, sigma va. Now friends, the most important trick or most important thing to remember in this particular multiplication table is that the sigma va, sigma vb and sigma vc planes, they remain fixed and they are connected to the initial orientation only. So at any point of time, sigma va is the plane containing nitrogen and hydrogen A as shown in the initial arrangement. Because what is going to happen is, I am explaining it to you, you will be able to understand it. See, we are trying to find out sigma va into c3. Now you know sigma va is the plane containing nitrogen and hydrogen A. So when you reflect it, then the positions of nitrogen and hydrogen A will remain stationary, whereas the positions of hydrogen B and C will be interchanged. So you see the result, the position A and nitrogen remains on their position only, whereas B and C are interchanged. And now we are performing operation C3. So C3 is rotation around this nitrogen by an angle of 120. So what happens, this HA will come to the position of HC. See, HA has come to the position of HC. This HC will go to the position of HB, and HB will come to the position of HA. So this is the result of sigma VA into sigma into C3. Now the same result is obtained if you perform sigma VC operation on the original arrangement of the molecule. So sigma VC is the plane containing hydrogen atom labeled C and nitrogen atom. So if you perform a reflection, the position of hydrogen atom C and nitrogen will remain same, whereas the positions of HA and HB will be interchanged. So see, HC remains same, nitrogen remains same, HB and HA are interchanged. So what happens? If you perform sigma VC, get the result, or else you perform sigma VA multiplied by C3, you get the result, both are going to be same. And therefore, in the multiplication table, you will be able to say that sigma VA multiplied by, I think it was C3, multiplied by C3 is equal to sigma VC. Just see, sigma VA multiplied by C3 is equal to sigma VC. Clear? So in the same way, let us say sigma v b into c3. Now all the time I might not have written, but you will be able to perform the operation very easily. See, instead of sigma v a, if I perform the operation sigma v b, then what I will do is the positions of nitrogen and hydrogen atom b will remain fixed, whereas the positions of a and c will be interchanged, and then on that result you have to perform c3 operation, and eventually you will be able to know that sigma v b into c3 is equal to sigma v a, and finally sigma v c multiplied by c3 is going to be equal to sigma v b. Now friends, as such, while filling up the multiplication table, the cells of the multiplication table, you have to check all the operations, but then there are certain characteristics of the multiplication table. You will see that in every row and in every column, not a single element of symmetry is repeated. Check any row or check any column, and all the elements of symmetry, they find a position in the cell. So if you have n number of cells in a row or a column, and if you have checked with n minus 1 positions, then the remaining is going to be the nth element only. For that you don't need to perform the operation. Now we'll try to understand the example which I have used to explain you that the group is non-abelian. C3 multiplied by sigma VA is not equal to sigma VA multiplied by C3. Let us see C3 multiplied by sigma VA. Okay, come over here. Your C3, your sigma VA, and this is the cell corresponding to C3 multiplied by sigma VA, and here it is seen that it is equal to sigma VB. Let us see C3 multiplied by sigma VA. So this is your oryndal atom, I mean ammonia molecule, and you are performing C3 rotation, that is 120 degree rotation. So what happens? HA comes to the position of HB, and then HB goes to the position of HC, right? A clockwise rotation of 120 degrees performed. Now here comes the most tricky part of this multiplication table. See, here I am performing the reflection sigma VA. Now you may feel that you will reflect this molecule in this plane, the nitrogen and hydrogen atom A, then you will be wrong. Actually, the original position of hydrogen atom A has to be considered. So this is not going to be your sigma VA plane. Your sigma VA plane is this one, because originally hydrogen atom A was over here. So in this picture it may appear that you are reflecting the molecule through sigma VC, but that is your sigma VA. So upon performing this sigma VA, you will see that the position of hydrogen atom C remains constant, whereas the position of hydrogen atom A and B are interchanged. Friends, this is the most important part of the multiplication table for C3V point group. Always remember that for considering the plane, you have to consider the original positions of the atom. So you have seen that C3 multiplied by sigma VA is now same as sigma VB. But then sigma VA multiplied by C3, here you can see, is not same as sigma VB, but it is equal to sigma VC. That is, the point group is non-abelian. So I have given you many examples of filling up the cells, and therefore now I am not going to use much of your time in treating each and every cell. I have given you the gist of the preparation of multiplication table. I have given you the trick that is required to remember. So that was something about the multiplication table for C3V point group. Now we'll go to one more interesting point group, C infinite V point group. Now these are the point groups, or these point groups contain molecules which have infinite fold rotation axis, and the examples can be any heteronuclear diatomic molecule. Say for example carbon monoxide. Now try and find out the principal axis of carbon monoxide. It is the axis parallel to the, or passing through the triple bond. Now start rotating the molecule around that axis, and you will see that while you complete the rotation of 360 degrees, the molecule will maintain the same appearance for infinite number of times. And in the same way, it will contain infinite planes of reflection, in which if you reflect the molecule, the symmetry will be observed. So any heteronuclear diatomic molecule, why heteronuclear, why not homonuclear, that I will explain you later on. But right now you have to remember that if you have a diatomic molecule and the atoms are different, then it will definitely belong to a point group called C infinite V point group, because it contains infinite number of axis or infinite fold axis and infinite number of sigma V planes. Next we'll take C and H point groups. Now these groups contain n rotation operators and n operators in which each rotation is multiplied in turn by sigma H. So you can have something like this, Cn means if it is say n is equal to 3, then you have C3, then you have C3 square, then you have C3 cube, but then you know C3 cube is Cn raised to n, so that is equal to E. Then you have Sn raised to n, that is you have a sigma H plane, that is a plane perpendicular to the principal axis, is also present in CNH point groups. Now CNH point groups contain double the number of n elements. So if you are talking about C2H point group, then it will contain 4 elements. Also remember that CNH point groups are abelian, that is the commutative relationship is maintained. Then the CNH point groups have the center of inversion I when the value of n is even, and if the value of n is odd, then the molecule will not contain the center of inversion. So for example, if you have C1H point group, then as I have said that it will contain 2n number of elements. So n is equal to 1, therefore 2n is equal to 2. The C1 point group, C1H point group definitely contains C1 axis, but you know that C1 is equal to E and the other element will be sigma H. In the same way, if you have C2H point group, then you will have 4 elements of symmetry. you have C2, then you have C2 square, but C2 square is equal to E, and then sigma H, and then you know that as n is equal to 2, in this case, n is even, and therefore center of inversion will also be present. In the previous lecture, we have already discussed this molecule in full detail. Trans 1,2-dichloroethylene. It is an example of your C2H point group. Now, here comes one more very interesting point group, CS. This is observed in tetrahedral molecules. Tetrahedral means like your methane. Particularly when the carbon or the central atom is connected to two or three ligands which are same. See in these pictures, in these two pictures, you can see that in the first picture, your CH2ClBr means two ligands are same, two hydrogens and two different. In this picture, you will see that three are same and the fourth one is different. Now what happens, whenever in a tetrahedral geometry you see that two or three ligands are same, then the molecule will have only one element of symmetry other than E, and this element of symmetry is your plane of symmetry. See what happens, you can consider a plane passing through chlorine, carbon and bromine. So on both the sides of the plane you can see that the molecule is equally distributed, and therefore it has the, that is the plane of reflection. So CS molecule in addition to E contains only a plane of reflection. It does not have any symmetry axis of rotation. That is why it is called CS. A specific name has been given. In the same way, in this case, you will see that a plane passing through hydrogen, carbon, and bromine will again divide the molecule into two equal parts, and therefore, here also the point group is going to be CS. Then comes the most interesting and very challenging part of this lecture. Friends, I have really worked very hard for explaining this particular point group to you. So, give full attention to my explanation, and you can also give me suggestions if you think that it could have been explained in a better way. But it has really tested my experience and intelligence, and so far I feel that this is the best way of explaining you the CI point group. So let me come to the molecule. Here I need to show you three pictures. As always, the left hand one, the left image is for your reference. The middle one is for first operation, and the last one is for the second operation. Now CI point group is assigned to the molecules that contain only center of inversion. They do not have any other element of symmetry, of course, other than E. They do not have any axis of symmetry, they do not have any plane of symmetry, but they are simply centrosymmetric. They have center of inversion. So, recall the definition of inversion. Inversion is rotation by 180 degree followed by reflection in a plane perpendicular to the axis of rotation. The example for this CI point group is a substituted ethane, your carbon, two carbon atoms, and on both the carbon atoms three different ligands are attached, your bromo, chloro and iodo. Even on the other carbon atom you have bromo, then this blue one is chloro and this yellow one is iodo. Most importantly, this is a perfectly staggered configuration. Staggered means, I will show you, perhaps you might have studied this in organic chemistry. See, you will see that this iodo and the other iodo are at extreme opposite positions to each other. In the same way, this bromo and this bromo, they are also at extreme opposites. Friends, today in this video, in order to make this concept easy for you to understand, I have used a special technique. And this technique is that the red colored elements, all the atoms that look red in color, they are coming outside the plane, whereas all the elements that appear blue are going behind the plane. That is, red atoms are outside the screen, whereas the blue atoms are behind the screen. And when the color becomes yellow, that is, it is on the plane of the screen. So we are considering this example, a substituted ethane in which both the carbons are attached to three different ligands and the configuration is perfectly staggered. You see the three ligands on the first carbon atom, bromo, chloro and iodo, they are red colored, that is, they are coming out of the plane, whereas the ligands attached to the carbon atom which is exactly behind your carbon atom number 1, they are all blue colored, they are behind. So let us see this now again in the plane. Now see, what I have done is, I have a chloro which is red colored, I have yet another chloro which is blue colored. It is this chloro atom number 4 is coming outside the plane, whereas chloro 7 is inside the plane. Whereas this I3, C1, C5 and I6, they are on the plane. This bromo is slightly outside the plane, this bromo is slightly inside the plane. Now I have to perform the inversion operation. Inversion operation means C2 multiplied by sigma H. So first I have to rotate the molecule at an angle of 180 degrees. Now for rotating the molecule at an angle of 180 degrees, I have to choose some axis. Which axis should I choose? Should I choose an axis passing through C1 and C5? If I do that, then I will end up in trouble and I will not be able to judge whether this molecule is centrosymmetric or not. That is, this molecule possesses the center of inversion or not. But what I have done, I have chosen an axis which is perpendicular to C1 and C5. And I will rotate it. come to the second figure and see, I am rotating it in, it doesn't matter whether it is clockwise or anti-clockwise because 180 degrees same. So because of this limitation of software, I will be rotating it anti-clockwise. But then what will happen is the position of C1 will be occupied by C5 and C5 by C1. That is, the positions of two carbon atoms will be interchanged. It will move like, I am showing it to you with a slow movie and you will understand. But when the positions are perfectly interchanged, the carbon 1 and carbon 5, I will stop. So see, here I stop. So you will see that I have performed a rotation of 180 degrees along an axis which is perpendicular to this C1-C5 bond. Now what I have to do, I have to reflect this molecule in a plane which is perpendicular to the axis of rotation. My axis of rotation was perpendicular to this C1-C5 bond. Therefore, the plane perpendicular to the axis of rotation will be a plane containing this I6, C5, C1 and I3. This will be my plane. So now I have to reflect in a plane which contains I6, C5, C1 and I3. You can see all of them are yellow colored, so they are in same plane. Now if I perform this reflection, then what is going to happen? Then you will see, when I perform this reflection, the positions of the chlorine 4 and bromine 2 will be interchanged, and in the same way the positions of bromine 4 and chlorine 7 will be interchanged. So let me first come to the figure number 3, and then I have to make it same as your figure number 2. First of all, now let me have it see, okay, this is same as figure number 1, and now I will perform your 180 degree rotation. So what will happen? Both the figures will become same, and then I will perform the reflection. See, I am performing the 180 degree rotation, and that rotation is now done. Now I am performing reflection through a plane which is containing atoms I6, C5, C1 and I3, and I know that the positions of bromine 4, chlorine 7 will be interchanged, and in the same way chlorine 4, bromine 2 will be interchanged. For that I am using a specified operation from this software. The arrangement of this molecule will be slightly disturbed, but then I will make it good for you to understand. I will rearrange it and you will be able to understand. Now just see, take a look at the figure number 1 and figure number 3. Are they same? No, they are not same. The atom numbers are different. Atom numbers are different, but see, the atoms are same. In the place of I3, you have got I6, but it is iodine. So appearance is going to be same. In the place of chlorine 4, you have chlorine 7, it's chlorine, position is same. In place of bromine, you have bromine. In place of iodine 6, you have iodine 3. There is a slight difference in color, but it is only because of my arrangement. I could have moved it a little bit, say, you know, something like this could have helped me in changing the color of this bromine, but you know, that is not really necessary. So you will see that if you do not consider the numbering, then the first figure and the second figure, they are having the same appearance, and therefore I will state that the compound I have shown in the figure possesses the center of inversion and it belongs to the Ci point group. So molecules of this point group have only I as the element of symmetry, of course, other than E. Now, why did we find this kind of symmetry? Only element of inversion. Because all the identical ligands were placed exactly opposite to each other. That is why we could find out, we could get the indistinguishable appearance by interchanging the opposite positions, which means that this molecule possesses the center of inversion I. Hence, this compound CiClBr, CiClBr is an example of your point group Ci. So, thank you very much, and in the next lecture, we'll discuss a few more point groups.